नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज बेटा हाउ टू प्रोटेक्ट द वर्कर्स इन अनऑर्गेनाइज्ड सेक्टर. देयर इज अ नीड फॉर प्रोटेक्शन एंड सपोर्ट ऑफ द वर्कर्स इन अनऑर्गेनाइज्ड सेक्टर. लेट मी गिव यू सम पॉइंट्स दैट हाउ कैन वी डू दिस. ओके, सो फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज द गवर्नमेंट कैन फिक्स द मिनिमम वेजेस. ओके, मिनिमम वेजेस रेट. Minimum wages rate and the working hours. Second point, that is the government can provide cheap loans. Okay, cheap loans means loans at the low rate of interest to be self-employed people. Okay, so that people can start their own business. Third point is government can provide cheap and affordable basic service. Okay, affordable basic services. Okay, what are the basic services? I told you before that basic services are the education, health, food to these workers, those who are working in unorganized sector. Next is government can frame new laws. Okay, new laws. Government can frame new laws which can provide the provision for the overtime, paid leave, leave due to sickness, etc. Okay, these were the few points by which we can protect the unorganized sectors. Next is the sectors in the term of ownership. Okay, if we talk about the ownership, our sectors has been divided into the two parts on the in terms of ownership, that is public sector and the private sector. Public sector. In the public sector, beta, government owns most of the assets are provides in the all services. It is under the government. Ownership is with government. These are the government owned. Okay, in the private sector, ownership of assets and the delivery of services is in the hand of any individual or the companies, private companies, any companies. Okay, railways and post office are the example here. Okay, railways comma post office and if we talk about here, okay, private sector. Okay, here government schools are also there. Okay, primary schools. If we talk about the private school, here is the Panacea. Okay, our Panacea school is a private sector school because its ownership is with the individual. Okay, and let me give you the another example, that is Tisco, Tata Iron and Steel Company. Okay, next, Reliance Industries, all these are the privately owned companies. And the purpose of public sector, okay, what is the main purpose of public sector? That is not to just earn profit, the main aim is the public welfare. Okay, and if we talk about this private sector, are guided by the motive to earn a profit. What they basically want to earn? They want to earn the profit. How they will earn profit? They will earn profit by providing the good services. Clear? So this was about the public and the private sectors. Now let us see about the responsibility of the government, that up to what extent the government is responsible in these activities. Okay, responsibilities of government. There are a large number of activities beta which are the primary responsibility of the government. Here let me show you some. Okay, so first one is the government raises money through the taxes and other ways to meet the expenses on the services rendered by it, means through taxes. Government raise money through taxes. Next, second is government have to undertake the heavy spending. Okay, government should undertake the heavy spending, like on the construction of roads, bridges, railways, generating electricity, providing irrigation through dams. Okay, also it has to ensure that these facilities are available for the everyone. This is the responsibility of the government to undertake heavy spending. Next, third point, there are some activities beta which the government has to support to encourage the private sector and to continue their production or the business. Okay, government should support and encourage the private sector. Support the private sector. Next point is the government in India buys wheat and rice. Okay, they buy wheat and rice from farmer at the fair price and sells at the lower price to the consumers through the ration shop. In this way, it supports both the farmers and the consumers. Support farmers and consumers. Running beta proper schools and providing quality education, health and education facilities for all are some of the duties of the government. Okay, what is the next? Providing quality education, and basic facilities, we can say basic facilities. Next, government also need to pay proper attention to the aspect of human development. Okay, human development. How? Such as like availability of safe drinking water, housing facilities for the poor and the food and nutrition, taking care of the poorest and the most ignored regions of the countries. This was your chapter number 2 of economics, sectors of Indian economy. Thank you so much, students. Thank you.